soon as I put the gloves on in the ring, my whole life changes. And it's the only time where I feel normal. It's a space where there is no Parkinson's.
Ripped, fit and fast on his feet, Steve Schiemer's a fitness instructor with Parkinson's.
At 39, I started to get some tremors in my hand and in my hamstrings. And when I went to the GP, the first thing he said was, well, you're too young and you're too fit, so it's not Parkinson's.
Turns out the GP was wrong, and 51-year-old Steve's now been living with Parkinson's disease for more than a decade.
There's definitely a process of grieving, especially because I identified myself with physical activities, and then to have that, you know, slowly taken away bit by bit, just little things start to change that you can't do anymore. Walking is one. Simple things like literally making a cup of tea. If you can't keep control of that, then you've got hot water going all over the place.
Parkinson's disease causes the brain to produce less of the chemical dopamine, which makes it harder for the body to coordinate movements. Doctors still don't know exactly what causes the disease, and there's no cure.
Most people with Parkinson's, especially younger onset people with Parkinson's, tend to hide it. I did. I hid it for as long as I could. And then you know, you get to a point where you have to own it.
An essential part of the treatment prescription should not just be medication, but also an exercise program as well. The evidence for different forms of exercise benefiting people with Parkinson's disease is extremely strong.
Despite 25 years of teaching the benefits of exercise, even Steve was surprised by the results.
So I thought within 10 years I'd probably be in a wheelchair or with a walker and have someone look after me. And I was right on the edge of the cliff, my toes were hanging over the edge, and I was backpedalling, trying to keep myself as normal as possible. And I felt like I was just about to lose that fight. And thank God boxing came along and hauled me back from the cliff.
They don't trade blows in the ring, but non-contact classes are gaining momentum here and overseas.
Most people look at Muhammad Ali especially, and he had Parkinson's, and so they associate Parkinson's with boxing. But it's the type of training, because with boxing you need to be able to coordinate your hands and your feet. You need to be able to think about the combination that's coming up, what your body's doing, where it is. It's about dynamic balance. It's about all these different things that create new pathways in your mind.
One, two, three, four, under.
It's about keeping yourself strong enough, and I guess, and fit enough to combat the things that happen to you when you've got Parkinson's. I've actually managed to push the Parkinson's back a little bit, and I'm doing better than I was 3 or 4 years ago.
Steve is so full of energy, and it gives you that encouragement. And he's my mentor. So I look up at him. Yes, I do.
The beautiful thing about Steve is he's not just a boxing coach or a trainer. He knows Parkinson's. And so we'd have long chats after the sessions. He's talking about the struggles of Parkinson's, and he's a wise old sage.
Anybody that has Parkinson's that's out there trying to help themselves, I think, is a bit of a hero as well, because it's something that's very easy just to give into. Despair and depression is really common amongst people with Parkinson's. And I can at least provide some answers and help them to come to terms with the fact that they've got Parkinson's and that it's not the end of the world.
Oh, I love that attitude, it's not the end of the world. The average age for diagnosis is apparently 65. You can imagine how interesting that is for people to step into the boxing ring for the first time at 65.
Yeah. Yeah.
We've done stories before on where even cancer patients during chemo, hospitals are now introducing gyms, exercise. It'd be remarkable to look back in sort of 10 to 15 years and see that hospitals and the way we approach these diseases is so different to what we used to do, which was just drug-based, and obviously they had a massive effect on them, on mental health.
Yeah, but it makes perfect sense the way he explains it, right? The opening of neural pathways, governing movement and stuff
the
like that.
The dopamine release. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it's counterintuitive because you think of that connection between boxing and Parkinson's, which I gather is actually not that straightforward anyway.
Yeah.
So it's just amazing that you find these solutions in like the weirdest places like that.
Yeah. And if you'd like more information on Parkinson's disease, you can head to our links page.